bit behind. I'm answering some of these, aren't I? Well, no time like the present, I suppose. They quite get off thinking I'll just answer to them every time they reach out. I suppose we'll have to deal with it though. We'll get some easy ones out of the way first. It is quite a shame that that enchanted quill of mine. Well. Out of enchantment. Some of the things needed for that I just can't get my hands on at the moment. I should see if I can get Cordelia to go out and get some of that for me. Nonetheless, I suppose this will have to do for now. It's going to be quite tedious having to write with an actual inkwell, but we will make do. Let's see. I believe first I owe a letter to our dear Dr. Febis, following up after her assistance. Oh, poor misfortune at the Pritchard's farm. Pixies, I believe it was. Yes. We'll see how they're doing. Dear Dr. Febis, all is well, and your assistant was able to return to you in one piece. I already mentioned this to them. Should they need any further treatment, they are more than welcome to pay another visit. I did further investigate the issue. My suspicions have been confirmed. By Mrs. Pritchard herself. I do need to decide how much of the story to dive into here. Mrs. Pritchard did say that I was welcome to share the tale. Perhaps if I just ask for discretion from the good doctor. As it turns out, the higher than average presence of Fae on their farmland was not imagined. Years ago, Mr. and Mrs. Pritchard were sewing for a child. That they made a rather reckless is too hard. Hasty. I made a rather hasty deal with the Fae. They use their magic to grant the Pritchards a child. The Fae would always be granted food and crops from the land. Naturally, the Fae spun the deal, and now they are henceforth welcome on the land itself. for your discretion on the subject. You of this, should any further patients plan the thing. My dear Dr. Febis, I hope all is well, and your assistant was able to return to you in one piece. I've already mentioned this to them, but should they need any further treatment, they're more than welcome to pay another visit. I did further investigate the issue. My suspicions have been confirmed by Mrs. Pritchard herself. As it turns out, the higher-than-average presence of Fae on their farmland was not imagined. Years ago, Mr. and Mrs. Pritchard were so longing for a child that they made a rather hasty deal with the Fae, that if they used their magic to grant the Pritchards a child, the Fae would always be granted food and crops from the land. Naturally, the Fae spun the deal, and now they are henceforth welcome on the land itself. I ask for your discretion on the subject, and only advise you of this should any further patients arrive at your doorstep from their farm. Warmest regards, Mira. That should at least cover their tracks nicely for now. I don't know what the Pritchards were expecting. Of course the Fae would give them a changeling. And of course they would fall in love with that changeling as their own daughter. They only welcome the Fae onto the land just to make sure she has friends, doesn't feel lonesome. I suppose if it gets too dangerous, we can always find a way around that, but I see no harm in allowing their daughter to live her life in peace. Fools. They're all fools. I'll let that one dry out. On to the next one. Now, I do believe I owe my dear Cordelia. Cordelia. I hope this letter finds you. As well as it can. Knowing you, I You are presently in pursuit. Some foolishly dangerous task. I've heard that you soon. I must admit was wildly curious. When I heard such news, everything fares well for your current crew. I hope everything fares well for your current crew. I know they're as close as kin to you. Oh, how do I put this without putting my nose in it too much? Should anything be amiss? Please don't hesitate to ask for assistance. I suppose we go with here. Anything else would be too sentimental for her. You know I'm always here. potential crewmate your way whenever you are back in port. Give my love to Ed. Cordelia, I hope this letter finds you as well as it can. Knowing you, you are presently in pursuit of some foolishly dangerous task. I've heard that you are in the midst of preparing another crew to launch soon. I must admit, I was wildly curious when I heard such news. I hope everything fares well for your current crew. I know they're as close as kin to you. Should anything be amiss, please don't hesitate to ask for assistance. You know I'm always here. I have sent a potential crewmate your way whenever you are back in port. Give my love to Ed, Mira. The fiery thing will probably just be angry at me for writing at all and inquiring before she's ready to talk, but something just isn't right with her asking for a new crew. She's a big girl. Whatever it is, she can handle it. Alright. Next, I suppose I owe a letter back to the Council of Wardens. Delightful. I don't think I'll need both pages for this. I'll keep it as short as possible. Should I address it to all of them? To Cure on Keep, to the Wardens, to the Council. I never know with them which one they'd prefer most. I think I'll just go with the classic. To it may concern. I can't say I wasn't polite. Thank you. Well, in dire map next time. On the matter. Of the curses, I know little. Best ask your head wizard. Thank you oh so much for your recent inquiries as to the state of my affairs. I can assure you that all is well in the Direwood, and you truly have no need to pay me a visit, however thoughtful the offer was. As to your other question, no, I have no idea why your couriers seem to be unable to reach me. Perhaps provide them with a more detailed map next time. On the matter of the curses, I know little. Best ask your head wizard. Signed, Mira. Well, if I didn't think they were already going to stop by soon, that should definitely get a warden down here. They really should learn to keep their noses where they belong, though. Alright. And on that matter, Chadryck. The audacity of him writing, honestly. Chadryck. Do I keep this one short and simple, or do I make it as fiery as possible? I think short and simple would insult him more, honestly. I'll go with that. No. No, you haven't. The faintest clue. Everyone from that town. Is calling you Chad. Honestly, he must think. Honestly, you must think I spent all my time solely thinking of you. Some of us are busy, you know. On that matter, precious Council of Wardens. To stop bothering me. Or can you not handle them on your own anymore? How does one sign off to him? Chadryck. No, I haven't the faintest clue why everyone from that town keeps calling you Chad. Honestly, you must think I spend all my time thinking solely of you. Some of us are busy, you know. On that matter, tell your precious Council of Wardens to stop bothering me. Or can you not handle them on your own anymore? Wishing you the worst, Mira. Oh, he should know better than to write me. This is what he gets every time and hasn't changed after all these years. The last of them. I don't even know what I say to her after all these years. I suppose some sort of greeting would be a good start. I find I cannot even begin. With a greeting. I hardly know what to call you anymore. Followers you amassed. Have so many names for you. I must admit, that I was surprised and nearly impressed. have heard. After our last conversation. Considering that I told you I never wanted to hear from you again. Time marches on around us. I find myself wondering if you remain as outwardly unchanged as myself. Or if you hide yourself in your citadel to conceal what time has wrought upon you as well. It must be so very cold there. This time of year. Well, I suppose you have enough unwitting fools there. questions you ask are of a complex nature. Best not left. Summary. Yes. Now the feelings have changed that you speak of. You know. Unable to travel to you. I'll see if I can contact a mutual friend. I may be able to arrange a meeting of a different sort. I agree. Fellow mage. That one is troubling indeed. I find I cannot even begin this letter with a greeting, as I hardly know what to call you anymore. After all these followers you've amassed have so many names for you. I must admit that I was surprised and nearly impressed to have heard anything from you after our last conversation, considering I told you that I never wanted to hear from you again. How time marches on around us. I find myself wondering if you remain as outwardly unchanged as myself, or if you hide in your citadel to conceal what time has wrought upon you as well. It must be so very cold there this time of year. I wonder how you fare without me to enchant your hearth, though I suppose you have enough unwitting fools there to light them for you. The questions you ask are of a complex nature, best not left to pen and paper, but in summary, yes, I know the feelings of change that you speak of. You know I am unable to travel to you to discuss in person. I suspect you have some reasons of your own. I'll see if I'm able to contact a mutual friend who may be able to arrange a meeting of a different sort. You and I might have our differences, but on this, we agree. Signed, fellow me. If she senses it too. What are the winds bringing with them? What is magic up to? I suppose I'll have to write to that mutual friend after all. After all this time.